He is a liar. Our prophet does not wear women's clothes. It was cloth. The word was cloth. It says he received revelation. When he is
But your prophet is not wrong calling me monkey.
Well, the Pope wears a dress. He's a liar.
The Pope wears a dress.
Cover yourself like this, or like a mist from around here. He married divorced or widowed women. Those had six children, six sons. And how can our prophet be unjust? She also said about marital rape. By the one whose hand is the soul of Muhammad, no woman can fulfill her duty to worship
What are you saying?
Yo, what's up, dude?
Man, like Mexican Andy in the house.
Hey, I got out of jail, dude.
Big chilling, you got out of jail in Scotland.
Out of the jail, dude. Hey, that was good content, huh? Crazy.
Damn.
Sunnah Ibn Majah. But the Quran says, O you who believe, it is not lawful for you to inherit women by compulsion, and do not make difficulties for them in order to take back on what you gave them, unless they commit and live morality, and live with them in kindness. For if you dislike them, perhaps you will dislike them again. Allah makes them in much more. He also said, she gave reference of Surah Baqarah 223. Provide our tilth for you. So go to your tilth, where or how you will, and send good deeds. She also gave reference of Sunan Abu Dawud. She is a liar. She did not quote that in Islam having anal sex is haram. She had actually lied last week. The one who deems it permissible is a kafir, and the perpetrator is a transgressor and a sinner. And after mentioning the prohibition of the front region, Jaina, the state government in those places, when they became pure, approached the well Allah has commanded you. But it's Jaina. On the authority of Abu Hurairah, the prophet of Allah, peace be upon him, the one who had intercourse with the menstruating woman, who had intercourse through a black passage. This is the belief in what has revealed to the Prophet. Surah Tabrizi, Volume 1,
So here's the Quran I am holding in my possession.
Yeah,
no
possession.
And I have it in the Quran. Muhammad's supposed to be prophesying the Bible.
How would you feel about
if Muhammad is not prophesying the Bible, Quran is a false book, Islam is false religion, Muhammad is false prophet. Here's the Quran.
You have a hole in it. You have a hole in it. You have a hole in it. Don't say you have a hole in it. You have a hole in your Quran. You're trying to say that you're holy. You're trying to say that you're holy with the Quran. You're holy.
Don't give the shaitan time. Shaitan, don't speak to her, don't give her time. She's a devil. She wants to provoke you, Peter, so she can put you on video that she look what Muslim is. She deserves it.
White people come ask me a basic question.
You have a hole in the Quran, you're telling me a basic question. What is wrong with you?
Mujahid.
You have a hole in the Quran, can I ask you a question? You have a hole in the Quran, you're saying.
Of course, don't answer.
And now you're saying.
But my question still stands. My question still stands. And the basic question is...
Yeah, what about the Turkish government? What about the Turkish government? Huh? The Muslim Christians and Muslims. Talk about them.
Let's look at the Quranic verse.
Okay, read it.
Don't give it to that translation. Don't give her any attention. Why are you so angry with God? Because he made you so ugly. She's so ugly, that's why she hates God. Your mom sat on your face when she gave birth to
you. Which man up on that? So those who believe in him and support him and have him and follow the light which has been sent with him, those are the successful. So according to this verse, Muhammad is described in the Torah as a
man.
I am asking the basic question.
Yeah, can I go?
What happens when evolution gets evil?
Yes.
Come over here.
That's the same thing. Natural selection says the fittest.